Apyayantu.
Om Apyayantu.
Mamangani.
Mamangani.
Vakprana.
Vakprana.
Chakshushrotram.
Chakshushrotram.
Athobalam.
Athobalam.
Indriyani cha sarvani.
Indriyani cha sarvani.
Sarvam Brahmopanishadam.
Sarvam Brahmopanishadam.
Maham Brahmani Rakuriyam.
Maham Brahmani Rakuriyam.
Mama Brahmani Rakarot.
Mama Brahmani Rakarot.
Anirakaranam Astu.
Anirakaranam Astu.
Anirakaranam Me Astu.
Anirakaranam Me Astu.
Tadatmani Nirate.
Tadatmani Nirate.
Ya Upanishatsu.
Ya Upanishatsu.
Dharmaste.
Dharmaste.
Mayi Santu.
Mayi Santu.
Te Mayi Santu.
Te Mayi Santu.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
We have been covering the Yoga Sutras. The first sutra in Patanjali Yoga Sutra. Patanjali Yoga Sutra. Atha Yoga Anushasanam. And Patanjali divided his Yoga Sutras into four categories. One is, first section is called as, why we are doing yoga? Yoga and its aims. And second section, he talks about how to practice. First, to know what is the aim of yoga. Second, how to practice. When you are practicing, and in the third section, it talks about we get many byproducts. Byproducts tempts us not to pursue yoga, drop off. Like for example, if I am proceeding from, driving from Melbourne to Sydney, on the way I get many towns, Shepparton, Yass, Canberra, many towns comes, and in the towns many attractions are there. They are calling us, come, come, you come here, you come here. They are tempting us, sail, clearance sail. Many times, if you are not focused reaching Sydney, you get sidetracked. Sidetracked with these temptations. They are calling us, so we go there, and our goal, we forget about the goal. And that is the third chapter. What are the temptations we get as a practitioner? On our way, many temptations come in our life. What are those temptations? And in the fourth one, if you do not yield to the temptation, and if you still continue, what is the product, the desired product? In the initial first chapter, it talks about the aim. That desired product you will get in the fourth chapter. It talks about in the fourth chapter. In the first sutra, I mentioned Atha Yoga Anushasanam. Atha, ah, means the most wonderful thing. Ah is the expression. It's something amazing happens, we say ah. Ah is an expression of joy. Ah, tatha, that most wonderful thing is pervading everywhere. It's yoga. To acquire that one, anushasanam. Let us be committed. Let us be serious in what we are doing. If you are not committed, you won't get not even the byproduct you will get, forget about the product. If you have to be very committed. Atha yoga anushasanam. And last week I touched upon to do practice, how long I have to practice. Yesterday in the yoga class, somebody asked, how many times a week I have to practice? And the Patanjali says, Satu dhirgakala nairantara satkaro sevito drudabhumihi. The practice, it is not a time bound, timeless practice. Satu dhirgakala, long time. And what about the cold days, long weekends? Today is Mother's Day. I want to go to restaurants. Can I skip? Or long weekend, can I skip? And public holiday, can I skip? Too freezing, can I skip? It says no intervals. Satu dhirgakala nairantara satkara. Satkara as an offering with a devotion, not because of the push from others. My family people are pushing me, my wife is pushing me, father is pushing me, son is pushing. No pressure. I should enjoy what I am doing. Satkaro sevito drudabhumihi. Dhrida Bhumihi. All practice should be to have the sustained practice. We need to have a firm foundation of knowledge, not an imagination, not on a shallow ground, or it's not on just on the faith. That person said, I will do. Have a knowledge with a firm foundation of knowledge. And knowledge doesn't come easily. I can have a Google, all the information is there. Or if I am talking, you are hearing, it's just an information for you. For your information, that's all. Information only. That information has to be translated into the knowledge through practice. To do that one, a seeker has to approach a competent teacher with humility, with a serious desire to know that one. I have to go to a teacher, competent teacher, and learn. And for that one, sincere commitment should be there. Faith should be there. In the one story I mentioned yesterday also in the class, in the story, it is about a serious student, an ideal student. Ideal student, it is mentioned by, told by Bhishmacharya in the Shanti Parva to Yudhishthira. Yudhishthira, Bhishmacharya was reclining on the deathbed on a bow of arrows, and Yudhishthira, the king, that he won the battle, and he went to his grandfather to guide him. And as an ideal king, how he should treat the subjects, how he should behave. And Bhishmacharya, in 20,000 verses, he talks about various, gives various advice to Yudhishthira. And one story, he talks about the ideal student. One ideal student was there called as Udanka. Udanka, he went to his teacher, Gautama and Ahalya. He went to the teacher. With great reverence, he went there. And along with him, many students also joined. He studied. He, with a great devotion, with great faith, and he was serving the teacher wherever he could. And however much he could, he used to serve. And the students joined along with him, got graduated and left. And Udanka did not mind. He was enjoying what he was doing. New batch came, new batch also got graduated and left. Third batch graduated and left. And he did not mind because he was enjoying. And one day, he went to the forest to get firewood for the ashram. He was carrying the load of firewood on his head, and coming down, that he did not realize he already had become old. But he had a lot of passion. And while carrying, and load was too heavy, and in front of the ashram, everything fell down. And his hair also got tangled up with the firewood, and part of the hair came off. He looked at the hair. Oh, it's all become gray. I have become old. And he started, tears started coming. I haven't even graduated. Many students came and gone. I have become old, and tears started coming. And I must be a very bad student. And the Gautama's daughter came and held her hands in front of his face. She did not want his tear to fall on the ground. And even that tears were so intense, even her hands got burnt off. And Gautama, his teacher, came and asked for the reason for his crying. He said, I must be a very bad student. So many students came and gone. I have become old. I am still here. And Gautama said, the reason I did not graduate you, not that you are not good, I liked you so much. I liked your sincerity, commitment. I did not feel like sending you off. Now you want to go, okay, I will graduate you. You can go. And also with this yoga siddhi, he made him even like an 16-year-old man with an energy. He gave the energy. That old man that Udanka is infused with energy. He became like a young student. And Udanka got graduated. He started his own gurukul. Hundreds of students came and studied under him. And once Krishna was meditating, he was going to Hastinapur, and he asked where he was going. Lord Sri Krishna said he was going to Hastinapur to make a conciliation with between Kauravas and Pandavas, so that he will try to avert the war. He will try to advise Duryodhana. And Udanka, he sat for meditation, long meditation. When he opened, Sri Krishna was coming back. And he did not realize how long he was meditating. Oh, that you are a lord of the universe. You have gone there. Your mission must be successful. Are they happy? Brothers are living together. And Sri Krishna said, no, that Duryodhana did not listen to him. War took place and Duryodhana got killed in the battle. And now the Pandavas are reigning the country. And hearing that one, he got so upset. Duryodhana had a knack of going to the key people and give them gifts and pretend that he was a very sincere student. He was pretending that he was a great student and he gave a lot of gifts. Udanka thought he was his favorite student and he got very upset. You killed my favorite student, I will going to curse you. And he took the water in his hand. At that time, Lord Sri Krishna revealed his cosmic form, cosmic Vishwarupa. Looking at that one, Udanka fell at his feet. He apologized for his moha. Because of his attachment to the students, he lost his thinking. Because he pleaded for pardon, Lord Krishna said, this cosmic form is not easy to be seen. Since he served his teacher so dearly, because of that one, he had a blessing of seeing this cosmic form. The cosmic form, that the benefit of this one, that ideal student, when committed, when you do that one with so sincerity, it won't go futile. And in the Patanjali, they say, one is a Dhrida Bhumihi, one is with a firm foundation, with full commitment, do that one, do the service, that information will be translated into the knowledge. And how to acquire Vitarka, Vichara, and Ananda, Asmita, Anugamad, Samprajnata, Vitarka, when you are taking the information, don't take it on the face value. You gather the information, whatever you are hearing, you gather. It's a time like when I was very keen student, like Lakshmi and some people, they bring the notepad also. I used to write down the keypad. I will go home and contemplate, make my own analysis. And it's you gather the information, gather the information, and vitarka and vichara, contemplate, gather the information and analyze, slowly that information, it has to be synthesized, and asmita, however great is the information, how relevant it is for my life. I have to apply to my life. However great is the, maybe a Nobel Prize laureate, he has given information. How it is relevant to me, my personal life? Asmita, I have to analyze the knowledge, information, synthesize, and how it is relevant to my personal life, how it will help. And when I start synthesizing in the knowledge dawns, one gets the immense joy within, ananda. Patanjali says, this is the process of translating the information into knowledge. Vitarka, vichara, Ananda Asmita Anughamat. You have to do this one. And to do that one, Shraddha Virya Smriti Samadhi Prajna Purvaka Itaresham. And Tivra Samvegana Masana. To do that one, Shraddha, faith. I mentioned about Udanka's story. Faith should be there. Faith and intense longing, intense commitment. Intense, the output is dependent on how intense you are. Tivra, it's a Shraddha, Virya. In Sri Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Shraddhavan labate jnanam matpara samyatendriyaha jnanam labdva param shanti achirena digachyati. Through the faith alone, one gets the knowledge. What is the use of knowledge? One gets unshakable peace within. And Shraddha, the faith is required. Shraddhavan labate. And we are nothing but a bundle of faith. Whatever we are, it's in the Bhagavad Gita, Sri Krishna talks about sattvanurupa sattvastha shraddha bhavati bharata shraddoyam purusho yashraddha evacha. We are nothing but what our faith is. Faith is very important. And the right faith should be there. Wrong faith will lead to our downfall. Ashraddhadana, one who doesn't have a faith, one who is samshayatma, always doubting, never believe anything. Samshayatma vinashyati, that person never rises in his life or her life. Faith is the starting point. Faith on a right platform and a right faith, not a wrong faith. And Shraddha, Virya and Smriti. Another one is develop the memory. When you have the intense faith, when you start liking that one, you remember. If I don't remember means I have weak memory, I forget. That means I have no interest. When you have an interest, memory will be sharp. And it will lead to you will get established in that one, that is called Samadhi. These are the steps for jnana, to acquire the jnana.